Hey, this is Nate Storey with Bright Agrotech, and today we're going to talk about using conveyor cropping techniques to maximize your light use and your system production. Today we're down here at Bayberry Fresh in Fort Collins, Colorado, and we're going to talk about how we can use the orientation of the towers and the sequence that they're in within a system to get the most out of your system. So this technique is called conveyor cropping, and it's different from batch cropping. Batch cropping is when everything is the same age group and you harvest everything at once. And the problem with batch cropping is that in towers, as the crops grow, they begin to shade each other out later in their life cycle. So to manage that and to get really good production throughout the life cycle of the crop, we do something called conveyor cropping. Conveyor cropping just describes moving immature towers from the front of the mast to the back of the mast. So all of our towers are oriented from north to south. They're all facing south. That's where the sun is, especially during the winter. And as we plant these towers, as we have these young immature towers, we introduce them at the front of the mast. And what we do is we take the tower in the front and we move it to the back, and we just move them all back in sequence, and we harvest the rear tower. So the idea here is that we're always harvesting from the rear, and we're always putting the young plants in the front. And what that means is that those young plants, because they're not very big yet, they don't shade out the crops behind them. So they don't actually impact significantly the production of the crops behind them. So you get this nice unimpeded transmission of light from the front of the mast to the rear. So the important thing to think about when you're setting up a conveyor cropping arrangement with inside of your system is to make sure that the towers slide really easily from the front to the rear. So make sure that instead of having to unhook these towers and move them down really labor intensively, you can basically just take your tower and slide it back. And that makes it really easy to move the towers from the front to the back. Another thing to think about is give yourself room either in the back or between towers to take towers out. So you can see that Hayden here has the towers spaced really fairly broadly, so it gives us lots of space to move back and forth between aisles, gets lots of good light transmission, and it allows us to take those towers out of the rear and move them forward really easily. So if you don't have space for another aisle, maybe before the next mass of towers, definitely think about giving yourself enough room between towers to get those towers out. So as you're thinking about setting up your system, make sure you're thinking about this particular technique. That is moving the young plants from the front to the rear of the mass of towers and harvesting from the back. We hope this information is really useful to you. If it is, check out our blog at ZipGrow.com. This is Nate Storey with Bright Agrotech. Today we're down in Fort Collins, Colorado at Bayberry Fresh with Hayden Christensen, the owner. And for those of you who know, he is one of the founding members of Upstart Farmers.